So you may remember vertical asymptotes from a previous course. A vertical asymptote is graphically, it's a dotted vertical line that the graph cannot cross and it approaches it instead. So in this example, this is the graph 1 over x squared that we were looking at earlier. On both sides of this vertical asymptote, it goes up to infinity and it cannot cross. Well, using calculus, we can actually define a vertical asymptote analytically or algebraically. And we do that by saying that you have a vertical asymptote whenever you take the limit as you approach a number and you get an answer of infinity or negative infinity. And from this definition, you can see that even if just on one of the sides you get infinity or negative infinity, it's still called a vertical asymptote. So even something that looks like this, so that side goes to infinity, and this side maybe has a hole over here, we're still going to call that a vertical asymptote. So an example of another function that would have a vertical asymptote would be the limit as x goes to 0 of 1 over x cubed. As you can see, this is going to be a non-zero number divided by 0, so that tells us it's going to be a vertical asymptote. But how do we know what the answer is? Does that mean the answer is automatically infinity? Well, no. If we look at the graph of 1 over x cubed, there's actually something interesting going on here. Because when we put in numbers bigger than 0, we get positive numbers. But when we put in numbers less than 0, we get negative numbers. So this graph actually goes in two different directions as it approaches its vertical asymptote. And if you remember from when we defined one-sided limits and we talked about the way limits might not exist, if you get a different answer coming from each side, that's exactly when, or at least one of the ways, a limit could not exist. So here we have the limit as x goes to 0 from the right side of 1 over x cubed going to positive infinity, and the limit as x goes to 0 from the left side of 1 over x cubed going to negative infinity. These two don't agree, and that means that the limit as x goes to 0 in general of 1 over x cubed equals does not exist. Now this brings up a really interesting question. If you have a form of a non-zero number divided by 0, what are the possible answers you could get? It turns out, if you're approaching a vertical asymptote from the right or from the left, if you're only coming from one side, you really only have two choices when it's the algebraic form of a non-zero number divided by 0. Either you go up or you go down. So that means that if you have the limit as x goes to a from the left side of f of x, that's either going to be plus or minus infinity. And if you have the limit as x goes to a from the right side of f of x, that's either going to be plus or minus infinity. So where does that leave us? That means if you're trying to take the limit in general, there's three possibilities. Either they both go up, and so you get an answer of infinity. They both go down, so you get an answer of negative infinity. Or one goes up and one goes down, and that gives you an answer of does not exist. You would also get does not exist with this strange picture we talked about earlier, where here you have a hole, and then on this side you have an asymptote. But we're not going to see any functions that look like that unless it's a piecewise function. So if you have an algebraic function that's giving you a non-zero number over 0, it is going to be one of these cases up here, and you're guaranteed that on the left side and the right side, the answer has to be either infinity or negative infinity.